Chunk's the best.
He's the best looking out of all of us. Give him that.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
You wouldn't go as far to say that he's the best looking we hang out with? You with that spider bite's looking pretty good. Yeah, dude, I know.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. It actually does kind of like look like something bit you.
Had to. I got one down here too, so I don't know.
All right, well now I don't know what it is.
What do you mean?
I'm kind of weirded out that
you.
You think so?
Well, I just watched like a UFO documentary, and I saw a guy that got abducted, and he had things like that all over his body.
I think it's the chupacabra.
Oh, the chalupacabra.
You son of a bitch.
Derek's been blood sucking.
In his bedroom at night.
He's been sucking your blood.
Nibbling at me for the past couple of years. Got bed bugs again. Just Derek sneaking in, taking sniffs at me. A filthy bug.
Oh.
Oh, God.
He's a dirty little bug.
Some weird ass fetish you got there.
I'm a little tape.
I like to crawl around at night. Night crawlers. How come we don't play night crawlers anymore, Frank?
What were you saying earlier before I said we should save that little story for the podcast?
Oh, yeah, so I'm not one to usually complain about fast food or like service in general.
Yeah.
And I always try to be like very, when people post it on Facebook or something like that and be like, these kids want $15 an hour, like, all right, blow it out your ass, dude, like. Minimum wage, whatever the fuck, you know what I mean? And then, like, they'll post other things. This is a side note. But, like, you know, they'll post other things like, want $15 an hour, doesn't even remember that I said no cheese. It's like, fuck off.
That's
right?
Stupid, dude, right?
Fucking, you know what I mean? Nobody gives a fucking rat's ass, alright? Just give the kid, if they're gonna get the money, then give them the money, okay?
Trump.
That's just my little personal thing. So, anyways, back to the original story. So,
Trump.
I spent fucking 20 minutes, I told you guys, it's fucking embarrassing. I spent like 20 minutes in the rain today changing a fucked up windshield wiper I have on the driver's side, right? So this is necessary when you drive now. It's necessary. If it's the passenger side, think about it. If it's the passenger side, you can get away with like not changing that for a while. This windshield wiper I had was halfway off.
Well,
like,
especially
it
if it's
flopping like as it wiped.
Especially if it's hailing out.
Yeah, so it was bad. It needed to go. So I finally fucking like nutted up, and I went to the local Wally World, snagged myself a one that fit, fought with it for like 20 minutes trying to figure out how the fuck it went off, because apparently there's so many different like types of it. There's like hooks, and then there's ones that you just clip in, and this is just really embarrassing pussy shit of me. That's some man shit you just gotta do, you know what I'm saying? Like, as a man, you really should know how to do basic things on your car.
So yeah, like you didn't have a good dad.
Like, if
I'm
you...
basically saying my dad was everything. No, it's just because I didn't want... You know what it is? I think about that all the time growing up because my dad is such a handyman.
His dad is awesome.
Yeah. My dad can fix shit. And like he learned from like just watching videos.
No, but yeah, if I see a guy that's pulled over on the side of the road and I see that he called AAA because he has a flat tire, I'm just like, oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Some shit. You gotta know the basics. Like, change it all. You can change your tire. You know what I'm saying? Changing your fucking windshield wipers is so easy that was embarrassing for me. I'm in the parking lot as it's pouring on me right now, right? Just reading the wet instructions that are just melting away in my hand as every raindrop hits it. Fucking men parking their cars, getting out, going to Walmart, leaving Walmart with what they bought, coming back to their car right next to me, getting like just watching me go like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Like just jingling around this windshield wiper, screaming at it as my girlfriend's in the car with the window rolled down and she'd be like, did you try it? Unclip it. Did you find the release? I'm like, woman, like, Chris, I know you're trying to help, baby, but like, it's not helping when you're patronizing me. You're like, well, it says in the instructions. She wasn't being mean about it. She was trying to be helpful. But it's just like,
nah, she was being mean.
It's getting to that point, though, where I'm like, where I'm just like, it's not fucking helping. I know what I'm looking for. And so, yeah. So anyways, I'm sitting there. I'm sure I got dads laughing at me.
It's
getting
like,
in their cars. Be like, look at this
they
fucking
all bought hammers and guns.
Yeah, like going in there just like, they're killing live animals in Walmart, coming back out with like a buck and being like, look at this fucking idiot. Can't even change a windshield wiper.
Yep.
Eventually, so this is, I guess, the most embarrassing part of this. I start swearing and freaking out like every anger. I'm freaking out like an angry dad. You know what I mean? Trying to put together like a fucking sofa from IKEA. I'm freaking out. Right.
What kind of dad? Dad from like Northeast or from
Northeast.
Like Deep South?
No, Northeast.
Oh, okay, good.
Like,
good.
Like the shit you see like any dad around here do. Just
okay.
Lose their shit.
All right. A lot of fucks.
I swear up and down. I got back in the car.
It's fucking late, dude.
My girlfriend knew I was pissed. She didn't say a fucking word.
Yeah, she
like, she was quiet. I thought I was going to get in there, she'd be like,
going back to
the instructions, but she knew right at the bat that I was fucking pissed.
Going back to what she said, she was like, when she was calling out, when Mary was calling out, like, to you, and you're just like, whatever you're saying is not helping. Yeah. It's like when you're looking around for something, and then all of a sudden someone's like, whoa, where was the last place you saw it?
Yeah.
It was like, yeah? Where was the last place I saw you? You don't think I already check the last place I saw it?
Yeah, for real. Or it's like, well, it's definitely gonna be, it's in the last place I looked. No shit.
Oh, I hate when people ask that.
Just stupid little phrases. But anyways, I go in there, and then I go on fucking YouTube with a fucking vagina. I go on YouTube to look up Chevy 04 Vala windshield wipers, right?
This is... That,
I find a video.
That is...
A video, 06 to 2011, Chevy Impala change your fucking windshield wipers.
If you don't have a dad, YouTube's your dad.
YouTube is a dad that... Dude, it's just one of those things, man.
You
can
get a PhD off YouTube, though.
Yeah, no, for real, yeah. The amount of shit that you can learn.
At least your associates.
He doesn't really mean.
Your associates? It's community college, YouTube community college.
Yeah, you can be like Matt Damon in fucking Good Will Hunting. You can just like go up to anybody in the bar and just be like, yeah, well, I know everything on this YouTube page, so.
Just fucking.
Start rattling off every.
Wikipedia. Is that a movie about like good thrift shop deals?
Yeah, no, that's a hunting trip. And he decides not to kill the animal on Good Will Hunting.
See, Will Hunting is a guy.
It's Good Will.
Oh, Will Hunting is a guy?
Yeah.
Good Will Hunting is looking for the best thrift shops store in the nation.
Which Savers has the best deals?
Good Will Hunting.
You should make your own, like, little YouTube channel.
I'm next on Good Will Hunting.
You probably get a stupid fucking deal on like TLC.
You probably could get a lot of views.
Oh god.
From just go.
Just having your name.
You go to Sam's and be like, "That's pretty neat." And just like,
just having reviews of shit at Savers.
We're here at the Salvation Army, North Branch, Massachusetts.
Oh dude, someone's gonna take this idea.
We're patenting it. We're patenting it. Don't even think about it. Anyways, I go in there, watch a fucking YouTube video.
Sidetrack.
Literally, it was the fucking easiest shit. I'm sitting there doing like the wrong thing, overthinking the whole process. It was just a simple clip.
Yes.
Clip in, clip out.
It's not too hard.
And it's fucking so easy. And I literally got back in the car after I cracked it in, sit down, and I was just like, the fucking easiest thing. And you know, my girlfriend starts cracking up. She's like, yeah, you fucking idiot. I'm like, yeah, I know, I deserve it. Anyways, I wanted this to be a quick trip. I decided to do the windshield wiper anyways. Quick trip where, you say?
Taco Bell.
To the old TB, son, the TB.
Oh, tuberculosis.
Yep, and this ain't no TB with the KFC. This is the OG TB.
Oh, man.
So I go there, and I went there
toilet paper.
Before. I'm on a Taco Bell binge right now. This is getting bad. I got food in my house. I'm leaving my house to go to Taco Bell. Fucked up, right? So first time I went there, it was like noon. She fucked up my sauce. I said, can I have some verde and some hot sauce? She just gives like a handful of fire, throws it in the bag, closes the window. I look in there, I'm like, not one verde, and I like my fucking verde, dude. And then I start thinking, I'm like, I know I mumble a lot, and noon, that's when I wake up. So I'm like already mumbling as it is, right? So I'm like, all right, fuck it. You know what I mean?
I'm still drunk from the next day.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I worked late, so I worked all night. And then I got up, and I talked about for breakfast, clearly. Best choice.
Yep.
And I'm sitting out there, and I'm like, all right, I'm just going to sit in the car. And then she'll come back to the window, which she was there. She didn't acknowledge me for like 3 or 4 minutes. And I'm like, all right, fuck. Well, I could just pull around, go ask for sauce, whatever. No, you know what? Fuck it. It's too early for me. Leave. Now today we go there. And this is the whole reason that we left, just to get Taco Bell real quick. Because I'm a fat fuck, lazy asshole. I get in the drive-thru, order my shit. Get there, there's like any sauce, and in my head I'm thinking, maybe I shouldn't assimilate and say verde. Maybe I'm too white. Maybe if I just say green sauce, she's gonna get green sauce, right? Like, but then I'm like, that's kind of insulting. Do I say green sauce? Do I have the right to say verde at the drive-thru?
Of course.
Being a white man, I mean, it's called verde sauce.
Of course.
Technically, it's salsa. Vinegar.
What do you call soy sauce? Are you gonna call it black sauce?
Yo, can I get some? What do you?
Are you gonna call soy sauce the black sauce?
No, but soy sauce is. I mean, what? How do they?
Soy is not an English word. I don't think.
I think it is.
I don't know.
Might not be.
Well, isn't like Japan really not? They don't call it Japan. They call it like Nippon.
Yeah, Nippon.
We just call it Japan. Yeah. Nah, Japan.
That sounds French. Japan.
No, yeah, Nippon.
Je m'appelle Japon. No, but anyways, I'm there. Fucking same woman. Seems like a very sweet lady. She was very nice at the drive-thru. Fucking, I get the bag of shit. We ordered like multiple shit, and sauce is all on point. I'm like, kind of some mild, some hot, some verde. Say verde, I say fuck it. I'm gonna go back to verde. She's gonna get it this time. She's gonna fucking get it. She got it. All in there. Word.
She better know what it is, because it says it right on the packet.
I'm saying. And it, so, I'm like, oh, is everything in there? My girl goes, I think so. I'm like, all right, there should be like four burritos and like a Crunchwrap. So whatever the fuck it was, right? We're missing two things, so I gotta pull around. This is after me getting soaked in the rain, fighting with a fucking windshield wiper, feeling embarrassed, and now I'm very hungry. Very upset. I'm full of fucking angry dad mode. I'm about to go in there and just be like, I got a fucking crying girlfriend in the car. All she was looking forward to was a fucking burrito all day. You know, obviously don't say any of that. They're very polite. I please and thank you. They shit out of them. Right?
Yeah. That's the white.
So fat.
That's.
She's been waiting on this burrito all day.
Yeah, and you being polite is the white part of the story. That's the white man move that you pulled.
The Yelp review after was the whiter part.
The Yelp review. I went on Yelp. Fitchburg Taco Bell. What the fuck? Yeah, no. But and now, well, cause I got out of the car and like Mary's like cracking up. She's like, oh, here comes angry dad. I was just like, I'm gonna put a new fucking asshole in that bitch right now.
Oh,
and
that's
what I said. That's what I said. I threatened her to my girlfriend's face. I was gonna rape this woman from the drive-thru. And Mary seemed alright with it. And I was going there. Please thank you the shit out of them. Give me my fucking two burritos. But she also had the audacity to ask for my receipt. Which I'm like, bitch, I literally just saw you. I was the last person you saw the drive-thru. Anyways, show her that shit, get it back. And I'll tell you what, she wasn't even worth my dick. So she had to fuck herself. That's what I was thinking. I was like, you know what? Even if I was gonna put you a new asshole.
Yeah.
Nah, literally take
it. Well, that kinda sums up the whole experience when you go to a fast food place. Because the odds are you're gonna get crap service, because it's either students that don't give a fuck about their job or people who don't really know how to perform their job to the best of the ability. And then that's why it's a dollar for a burger. And then fucking,
I had a very nice pleasant experience at Wendy's.
Well, yeah.
It was pleasant.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was great for me.
Well, it was good for Derek.
We did a number.
Yeah, he did. He did, dude.
That's gross.
Yo, dude, it was disgusting.
Oh, was she hot?
It was the first number Derek got in 4 years.
You know what's funny?
She told us to pull over to the side, and then she told her little minion man to run out, and then he was just like, "Here's your sandwiches." Oh yeah. And this is from the girl in there. And she, like, handed Derek a number.
I was really hoping it was his number.
Oh, yeah. Was she good looking?
Oh yeah.
Give
me ethnicity.
She was white.
Trailer trash white. And,
nice.
So, what happened?
Juicy Couture white? Trash?
Yeah, Juicy Couture.
She was fat.
White. And,
quite juicy.
And so what happened was, he gives me the number, and the second he gives me the number, I roll up the window, put my car in reverse, and leave. Like immediately. Like.
She went to the drive-thru again, and she'd be like, I didn't know how you felt. This is a great little experience we had right here. Should we?
Wonderful dude.
If I had known that you felt that way, I would have saved you from this place the second I saw you.
When you're on break, let's split a Baconator.
Hop in this neon girl.
No, baby. This baked potato's for two.
Hop in the front of the seat of this neon. I'll putter right out of here. Drive off into this horizon.
Sit on my lap in this neon, bitch. You're gonna have a good time tonight. That's gross.
So I came home and I put her number on Google just to see if her number was...
Escort.
Yep, so I...
She's an escort?
No, just, no, just to see who she was, though. And man, was she a bulldog.
She was a bulldog, and she was like a dropout. She was like a 17-year-old dropout.
How'd you find her through her number?
Because it's on Facebook. People don't realize, dude. Like, you link your number to all your social media. I just type in your number, and then, boom, this girl comes up. And then,
holy shit.
So yep.
She's like 17, 18. She
bulldog?
Bulldog. Oh, yeah. Dropped out of high school, has a kid.
Love the dick.
Oh my god, I'm okay. So yeah, she's my girlfriend now.
So the moral of the story is
she's my fiance.
That's how I met my wife.
Turns out that was actually my kid.
Oh, Jesus. My kid. I bet she's down to clown too.
She was a juggalo.
What'd you order?
I was getting some fat food.
Yeah, no, we got nothing. I think we got a bunch of food that time.
I think I was still giving up at that point.
Yeah. Oh, man. He was on the turnaround. Yeah, but that was when he decided that he was going to just turn his life around and then try to step his game up so that way girls like that don't hit on him.
Yeah.
So now, basically what you're saying is now you go to drive-thrus at Arby's?
Yeah.
For Arby's number
and stuff. We go to Boston Market now. We actually have to get out of the car.
I don't know what it is, dude. I always just tell myself I should just go to Subway, but for some reason those hot little mixes just crumble. I can't do it. They ask me for like all.
Oh yeah, those 15-year-old sandwich artists.
Yeah, what the fuck? What are you talking about?
No, I did.
These girls in high school just paying their part-time fucking wages.
No, I just crumble. They can't go in there. I'm just like.
Oh yeah, I just can't.
Too much pressure.
I just can't build up the confidence to say. Tomato.
I know.
What do you?
I'm like, I don't know. I'm just like, I have
I'll
to
take a Subway melt. Any veggies or toppings today? No. just tuna salad.
I think it's that old inner fat kid.
He's the one that. he's the one that buys extra shit to try to impress him. Like,
green peppers on all the veggies. Every single veggie.
Run it through the garden. And then she's like, hey, do you want any cookies or a drink? Yeah, I'll get the biggest drink and I'll take the whole rack of cookies. Whole rack of cookies. Is that you guys take tips here? Oh, here's a 20. Fuck, I have no gas.
You guys do cooking about the piece? I'm for a rack. Just give me a rack. Top rack.
You got a rack rate?
A bundle deal?
You
remember.
You get commission on this, honey?
I'll tell you what I'll do for you, baby. I'll tell you what I'll do for you.
Hey, Janice, come here.
hey, sweetie. Toots, you get our commission on this shit?
Actually, the last time we went to Subway, it was after a casino trip. And we go into Subway.
Oh, it was so weird.
And this kid is this little fucking, you know, little twink, like punk rocker kid. And he fucking looks at us and he's like, so, you guys look like some punk rockers. We're just like,
what?
Right after we came back from Foxwoods or Mohegan or something like that. And we're driving back. It was probably, I don't know, 11:30, 12 o'clock at night. And then we stop at Subway. And then, yeah, we walk in there. There's no one there at the, where they're making sandwiches, asking them what you want.
Yeah,
this kid comes from the back. And then he has blue hair and, like, fucking, like, goth wristbands and stuff like that. And he looks maybe.
Did he have the chain wallet?
Yeah, it looked like he had a chain wallet and JNCO jeans. But yeah, no, he was probably 17 at the most.
Yeah, okay.
And then he saw me and Derek. And then, yeah, he asked us the first time, and it kind of threw me off guard. And I was just like, what the fuck? And I was like, nah, we just came from a comedy show. And then he was like, oh, yeah, well, just like, all right, yeah. And then he didn't say anything for a second. And then maybe like 10 seconds later, he's like, well, just like you guys' look, I don't know. Like, you guys look like punk rockers or like skaters or something. And then.
He was profiling you. Well, also, he was probably for some conversation.
It was very weird. And then.
Well, what
but
the fuck
what,
were you guys wearing? Well, from a casino?
Just normal clothes, t shirt, fucking pants. Nothing crazy. It's not like we're.
Mini skirt.
Yeah.
nicest blouse.
It's not, yeah, it's not like I was wearing the Jenko jeans in my chain wallet.
Well, I mean, especially when you go to a casino, you try to look nicer.
Well, yeah, no, if we weren't. Anything, so I'm thinking, like, we weren't, like, dressed up or anything. Well, yeah, I was wearing, like, a black t-shirt and jeans. And then,
with the long hair and like the dope smoke,
but,
pouring out you
motherfuckers. No, but yeah, but and we were thinking about it too. Like, what's the what's the correct answer to that? Like, what was the answer he was looking for? Like, yeah, dude, we're fucking punk rockers, bro. Rock. Like, fucking, yeah. You want to come back with us? We're gonna go listen to some G.G. Allin and fucking spit in each other's faces. Blah. Fuck off, dude. Just like,
what he wanted.
I think he was looking to
Yeah, it was kind of weird.
At least that's what I wanted from him.
Why do you
guess
trying to fuck you in the butt?
Then? Gas station at midnight? Trying to fuck.
Oh, definitely for the dick.
Have you guys ever seen do you guys know who G.G. Allin is?
No, I didn't get the
reference
at all.
He's
that was a polite laugh.
Yeah, that was effort.
But he's a fucking punk rocker. And he has
G.G. Allin.
And he is known for shitting on stage, or he was known. He's dead now, but he was known for like defecating on stage and like throwing it at the audience, spitting at like fans and stuff like that.
Oh, someone's
in
my opening.
Like, yeah, someone.
So he's like the Gallagher of punk rock.
Pretty much, but but yeah, no, he was. He was on Jerry Springer, I think, or fucking Oprah or some shit.
As a headliner?
On Oprah?
Yeah. Yeah. Springer, as a co-host.
He was on Jerry Springer or Oprah.
Yeah, one of those two. One of those two professional broadcasts.
He shits on
stage. Yeah, he's on Oprah. And our new book club of the month, G.G. Allin's here to introduce it. Just shits on the book.
But, some of it, though, I don't even
understand. Was G.G. Allin?
Yeah, it was just G.G. Allin.
G.G. Allin and the Shit Eaters.
I'm not too sure if the other bandmates are known that well, but...
The Defecators? Yeah. Probably the Deftones. G.G. Allin, Deftones. They couldn't say Defecators, so they just went Deftones.
But yeah, no, some of the shit is fucking crazy. Yeah, he would get into fights with his fans in the middle of his shows and shit like that. Yeah, he was on Jerry Springer, not Oprah.
I've been crushing that show Vinyl. HBO, fucking Scorsese and Mick Jagger are executive producers. And it's great. A lot of drugs, a lot of sex, rock and roll, you know, HBO. But like Rolling Stone and like Mick Jagger's son is like a punk rocker, kind of like what I guess this guy would be doing, so he doesn't shit on stage and shit like that. He fights.
Punk rockers, dude.
Yeah, 80s kind of shit. It was cool. Man.
But this is this is an example of some of the shit that he would do on stage. Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna write him. Oh, I guess not.
No,
it's just a lot of him fighting fans and him in his thong. Yeah, it's pretty sexy.
No, I mean, it's pretty cool.
Like Derek said, someone filmed his open mic.
Dude, he's really trying to beat the shit out of this kid.
Oh, yeah, no, they don't... Yeah, they're not fucking around.
That's pretty awesome.
Mm. Oh.
Jesus
and
Christ.
And that's how it ends.
Actually, I respect the shit out of that.
I don't at all. It's pretty weird.
I mean, that's Settles Records.
That's fucking art, bro.
That's fucking punk rock.
That is punk rock. That is fucking punk rock. That is, like, that is as metal as you can get, really.
Yeah, dude.
If you're trying to fucking chin check...
Would you go to that show?
No, not. Oh God, no.
So pretty much you just said that's how you sell it, but you wouldn't go to the show.
I mean, I guess I'll go in the back. I'm not. I don't even know what he sounds like. We didn't even get to hear any of his music, so I don't even know.
It's pretty bad.
It's probably just thrash. It's probably just thrash punk. Just sounds like crap. Heavy chords, and that's it.
Yeah, it's a lot of
whatever.
A lot of shit that you can't understand.
Well, I fucking
cut my wrist and black my freaking eye.
I hate you, motherfucker. I hate you motherfuckers. I hate you motherfuckers. I hate you motherfuckers. I hate you motherfuckers. I hate you motherfuckers.
I'm heavy,
I hate you motherfuckers.
Yeah, no, like literally sick. He probably has AIDS.
He probably has something.
No, he's dead. But I don't know how he died.
Wikipedia, dude.
Probably died from fucking eating feces.
Probably. That sounds awesome.
But like if you do live life like that, I don't see you making it to 78. You know what I mean? When you live in life, when you're redlining your engine all the time.
Yeah.
I don't really see you making it.
I mean, you look at people like
Stitches.
Well, yeah, Stitches. But I'm thinking more like Black Flag. You know what I mean? Like, who's the lead singer of Black Flag?
I don't know. Why don't you name some other bands I don't know?
Black Flag. You never heard of Black Flag?
That's a racist and a sexual.
Anyways, the lead singer of Black Flag, like that dude, fuck man. He was the second lead singer, but he's like one of the more famous ones. I can't remember his fucking name, but dude, that guy's gonna live forever, bro. That guy's, he's in really good shape for being like 50 some odd, however. But also, they were kind of into the straight edge punk. I mean, not really. Black Flag really wasn't, but like that was the beginning of that shit, like Minor Threat and all that. Like,
they were the creative punk rock.
No, they were still like shitheads.
The creed of punk rock.
But you know, I don't know. I've been getting, I just went to the, went to a little vinyl record store a couple days ago, just kind of on a whim, because I got a record player.
Tim on a whim.
Tim on a whim. That's my memoir. Tim on a whim. Jesus Christ, that's awful. Timmy on a whimmy.
Going on a limb, it's good.
Tim on a limb.
So
Tim on his last leg.
So this is the the story of Gigi Allen's last night, which is probably where Tim's last limb is gonna end up.
Let me hear it.
It's gonna be all right. So it says,
Gigi Allen's last night.
Yeah, Gigi Allen's last show was on June 27th, 1993, at a small club called the Gas Station, a punk venue. Located inside a former gas station at 194 East 2nd Street in Manhattan. And it says, during the second song, the venue cut the power, after which he trashed the neighborhood, walked across the street entirely naked, covered in feces, blood, and just wearing shorts, followed by a large group of fans. After walking through the streets for almost an hour, Allen eventually went to an apartment owned by John Handley, a.k.a. Johnny Puke. There, he and others continued... who knows? Doesn't specify who's caca it is.
Interesting.
But it says, there, he and others continued to party and use drugs. Sometime during the evening, Allen ingested large amounts of heroin, on which he accidentally overdosed and slipped into an unconscious state. Those in the apartment posed for photos with Allen as if he was Bernie from Weekend at Bernie's.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
It doesn't say that last part, but I thought about it. And it does say that people posed with photos until 2 a.m., not realizing the musician was already in the early stages of respiratory failure.
Well, when you're hanging out with those type of
bunch
people,
of fucking retards.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. You're not chilling with a bunch of surgery.
36 years old.
That's how old he was?
Yep.
He looked like he was 45.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did.
And that's when I saw him in his prime, it seemed like.
That was when he was 21. That's fucking terrible.
Well, you have to think about the type of lifestyle that guy was living.
I mean, he probably... Honestly, that...
How...
If he was told that's how he died, like, somehow you could be told, like, no, no, he died. This is how he died. In some sort of, like, afterlife setting or whatever, he'd probably be like, fuck, yeah, that's how he died.
Yeah, no, I was gonna say, like, he was probably the type of person that was just like, goddamn right.
Yeah. Up, covered in shit.
Like a fucking G.
Yeah, for real. Jesus.
I'll be remembered. Yeah, as the guy covered in shit, snorting fucking heroin.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know, dude. That's pretty interesting. I'll have to look for his vinyl. Like, so I'm gonna go to the record store.
I'll be the one covered in poop.
I'll just be shit brown album.
Yeah, you can be immediately put on the FBI's fucking list.
I don't know. I went there. Well, so So I got a record player, and I've been spending copious amounts of money. Yeah. Because for whatever reason, I mean, not all vinyls. Like, I got a couple pretty good ones for like $7. You know what I'm saying? Like, good albums that like I enjoyed listening to or whatever. But I bought one. You know, and some of them are just rare. You can get the ones that are like white marble vinyl, or a certain press. It'll be like UK pressing or original press. Or like I saw like a Black Sabbath original, is it Virgo tint or something like that. They said original pressing from like 61.
That's pretty cool.
It was selling for like $250.
Hell yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, and he just got that one too, and I was just like, oh shit. Because I heard him talking to some lady about it, and I was like, oh, you talking about this one right here? And he's like, yep. And then I was like, oh.
So did you get the Sabbath one?
Yeah, just to say I spent all my money. No. No, I didn't. I got I got Dr. Hook. I got Dion and the Belmonts.
Four top.
That doo-wop.
Real nice.
It's the pussy wet, alright?
And then you got some Yardbirds.
No, but they were there. I didn't get any.
Of course.
I spent the most money, the most expensive record I bought that day was Tom Waits. It was like $35, original pressing from 80.
That shit's barely music.
That shit is great. Quality fucking music. But unfortunately, he said he had a better...
On such great sounding system, you decided to waste it on such terrible shit.
I fucking loved it. It's so good. And,
do you like the way it sound now?
That album I bought was the heart of Saturday Night, and that was when he was young, before he started doing, like, too much experimental shit. It's more of, like, a jazz, if you will.
So it's shit?
It's fucking great. Fucking great. And so I bought that.
It's fucking great.
And I bought Little Feet, just a live album of them. I bought Tribe Called Quest, Midnight Marauders. Had to. They didn't have too many hip hop albums. He said that some guy, the guy told me, so I was like, how many like hip hop do you have? Because I saw they had Outkast, which one was it? Aqua something? Or it was an ATL Aliens. It was the one before that with like Rosa Parks up on the album. You guys know what I'm talking about? Like one of the older ones. Anyways, it was kind of expensive. So I was just like, hey man, like how many, like what kind of hip hop like collection? What kind of hip hop collection do you have here? And he was like, honestly, we only have a lot of like one tracks. Because a lot of times people come in to buy hip hop albums, they're buying them to mix and scratch with, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but how much are they charging for one track?
Like $9. $8. And wow. And you get like the instrumental, you get the instrumental remix, then you get like the edited, the radio edit.
Still a decent amount of money though.
Oh yeah, of course. He said that some guy came by. He's like, we had a DJ come by from Connecticut. He said just a couple weeks ago, and he's like, he bought $4,000 to $5,000 worth of fucking single tracks. Wow. He said he filled up his truck. He said just one sitting.
Really?
Yeah. He was just like, yeah. He just grabbed him. He's like, yo, just give me like all your hip hop.
Do you think he was like a producer or something like that?
You said he was a DJ.
Yeah. Wow.
So, I mean, that's the best way to do it, too, because honestly, like, instead of nitpicking, it's just like, all right, I'm just going to get a fuckload, and I'm going to find something that maybe I didn't even know about, or even realize that I can mix with and, like, scratch with. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I thought that was pretty cool. So I didn't really get too much hip-hop, unfortunately. But
scratching the vinyl, bro.
Dude, I dropped, like, $80. Like, at one point, I had to tell myself, I was like, all right, I got to fucking figure out which ones I
really want today. Yeah.
Because I can always come back. But also, he was like, he just got that Tom Waits one in, and he's like, yeah, Tom Waits doesn't really stay around too much. I was like, oh, I'm getting it.
Man,
I was already
man.
Designing to get it, but he's like...
So out of the things that you did get, you decided to get some shit.
So good. I got some E Street Band.
Derek, you got me one of these.
And, so I've just started that obsession of buying vinyls and shit like that. Got a Primus one. That one's pretty sick. It's just cool, man. It's just cool having, like, the crack and, like, the sound and, like, just having, like, the... Just a nice, like, album.
I actually have some vinyls here. Fucking.
What do you got?
Some old Portuguese albums.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you showed me
those. Yeah, I showed them to you.
Yeah, those are cool.
I think one of them is
Modelo. I think one of them is an old Popeye one.
Yeah.
But it's like, I think it might be in Portuguese.
Dude, you know what they had a fucking surplus of at the record store? So I saw George Carlin. George Carlin one, but it was like a greatest hits.
Son of a bitch.
No,
Wait, you saw George Carlin?
I saw George. So I saw George.
Dug him up.
He was propped up in the record store. Just bones. No, but so I like caught my eye. I was like, oh shit, George Carlin, this would be cool. But this is the greatest hits like compilation. So I was like, ah, fuck, I'm not gonna just get like.
I can't jerk off to this.
It was like when he was really young to like really young. Like I'm saying, like probably before like even like.
Like when he was doing like the Weatherman stuff.
Yeah, and like mother-in-law jokes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It was before like he did like the seven words you can't say.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm kind of I like Carlin. I like later Carlin.
Yeah.
But like back in when he was
late
doing 70s,
like the 80s, but like this was like 60s.
He had his own show for a little bit.
Did he?
Well, he was on a show, and that's where he did like the Weatherman bit and everything. And he was
probably Carson, right? Was it Carson?
I'm not exactly too sure.
Oh.
But yeah, it was funny for the time, but definitely doesn't hold up.
Yeah.
But all the shit that he did past the seven words that you can't say,
yeah,
all that shit holds up forever.
Oh, it's fucking awesome, dude.
Yeah.
And when he just sits there and just preaches and rants, dude, that's like fucking some of those brilliant shit, because sometimes it's not even comedy, it's just him being like, you know what really fucking pisses me off? He's like, pussies, like, pussy, you can't say pussy fire. So like, he has a whole thing on like suicide.
Or the name Todd and Kyle.
Yeah.
And shit like that. Like, but he was a guy that like ripened with time. Like, he got better as he got older. Like, he was good until the day he died.
Yep.
And he was still going too. He was doing shit until he was dead.
And he was sober too.
And the crazy thing too is that he did one every year. Like one every year and a half or so.
He did one. He had his HBO special that he did like a couple years before his death. One of, like one of the cooler ones, man. It's just cool, like such an old man, like
yeah. You know, sober, you see him go. You see him go out there as an old man. And he starts saying shit that
like
you.
Like off the top of his head, like
it's like when we go out to breakfast with Grandpa Mike, and then if you were someone that didn't know him, and then all of a sudden you start seeing him talk. And he's like, and you see him like saying it in front of his grandkids. He's like, oh, these fucking cunts and shit like that. And then you're just like, oh God, this guy's fucking dead serious.
The real deal, yeah. Just like, there's nothing better than that kind of humor. And
yeah,
that shit
yeah,
from like, you know, being a New Yorker or whatever. You
it's
know
the
I'm
best.
Saying? It's just pissed off. It's just somebody getting pissed and you're just laughing and you're loving it.
Yeah.
So anyways, I saw the George Carlin thing, caught my eye. So immediately I started looking through the thing. They had a fucking surplus. I'm talking a major fucking surplus. Bill Cosby.
Oh, really?
So much Bill Cosby, dude.
Everybody returning it?
Yo, yeah, and it was dirt cheap. I even brought those. You got an awful lot of Cosby over here, man. And he's just like, yo, they just keep coming in and I can't get rid of them. I can't fucking get rid of them.
Really?
I was like, I fucking believe it, dude. Well, they weren't like anything good. It was like one of it was.
Who's ever gonna buy those?
Cosby fans.
People would buy. Dude, there was one for like a $1.99 of just like Fat Albert. Honestly, like
someone who has definitely raped over 20 women.
Well, I mean, I would buy. I guess I would buy a good one, just to have it because it's kind of funny. Be like, why the fuck? Like, out of all the
yeah, dude, rape's funny.
Music, and all of a sudden, it's just Bill Cosby. It's weird they didn't have it in your collection, but
yeah.
I don't know. I just noticed.
I never really enjoyed him as a comedian, to be honest. I know that he's one of the most prolific ones and most successful over the years, but me personally, oh, there's a burp. But me personally, I never really found him, like, hilarious. He never made me die laugh. Like,
yeah.
Some of the other guys, like Dave Chappelle, like, I remember times where I was sitting on the bus going to school, listening to Dave Chappelle,
yeah,
where he made me die laughing. Like, fucking,
yeah.
I was like, fuck, like, I think I died.
I'm not even there right now. My heart failed. I literally had heart failure.
It's where you guys realize I'm schizophrenic.
Heart palpitations. Damien died that night.
Yeah.
And so Rose, the beginning of Jerry.
I've been Jerry this whole time.
I was the guy jerking off on that bus Dave Chappelle was on.
Yeah, but, no, I totally agree. It was fucking, I don't know. It's just, I've been really getting into the whole vinyl thing, and it's cool. Like, I've been trading vinyls. I just traded vinyls with my buddy. Gave him a few that he wasn't familiar with. And then, you know, I get to go through his shit. Like, I grabbed, like, Talking Heads, and I got a live B.B. King.
A lot of Barry Manilow and...
Yeah, Rod Stewart.
Culture Club.
Yeah, David Bowie.
Barry Manilow.
Like, Cocaine's 80 David Bowie when he was, like, probably bisexual but couldn't admit it.
Derek just said Barry Manilow.
Fucking take a lap, dude. It's a fucking culture. You guys know that David Bowie was like pretty fucking gay. Did you hear that Lou Reed?
Of course, dude.
David Bowie was gay. He's not
gay. He's pretty gay. Dude. He was bisexual.
He had a black wife. He never even on record.
That makes him gay.
But he had a.
What a fag. I bet he eats pussy too. What a fag.
Dude, he was gay. He had a black wife.
You know he was gay. He married a black woman.
You like black women.
I bet he eats pussy too. What a faggot.
What I meant by that was he had a black.
He's not gay. He never even said he was bisexual. All he said was
He did have a wife who said that she caught him in bed with Mick Jagger.
In that video they made too.
And if you ever seen that video they made, in the street, it is very suspicious.
You're saying that Mick Jagger and Dave Bowie were like jerking each other off something?
Of course I'm saying that.
That is the most ridiculous shit. I don't believe it.
Dude, you want to watch that video? I can show you. I'll show you 1 minute of dancing in the street with Mick Jagger and David Bowie. And you're going to be like, wow. You're going to be like, wow.
Dancing in your ass.
No, you really are going to be appalled by how.
Dude, what was that song about? Like 80s?
Yeah, somewhere in the 80s.
They're all fucking little fruity weirdos. That's how it went. I don't know. That's all, very sexual. They're all very sexual people.
No, David Bowie was sexual in the aspects of he swung both ways. He was definitely bisexual. Just look at him.
Derek's like, yep. You don't even know. I'm surprised you even know who David Bowie is, you prick.
Dude, name. what was David Bowie's nickname?
Is that the motherfucker that just died?
Yeah.
The gay boy.
No,
Ziggy B, Big Dick,
Gold Dust.
Dude, look at. All right, so I don't even have to click on the video. The very picture frame of the video that you click on YouTube, the very first one that has 15 million views. Look at what's on the view or on the little title screen. Right there.
I'm clicking.
Yeah, did you see it though?
Yeah, they were close.
They were kissing.
They weren't kissing.
Oh, they were close.
If you saw one of us doing that at paintball, you'd have been like.
France and Germany!
Fucking right. Hey, yo. I'm not too sure if we can play the song like this, but.
Why? You gonna get trouble with copyright something?
I think so.
Can we?
Yeah, like anybody watches, anyways.
Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching, Derek.
Thanks to our best fan, Derek. That is, dude. You can't deny that right there. They both have makeup on, and they're a centimeter away from kissing.
Deny what? They're singing the song.
So you're okay with?
If they were sharing a microphone, that's what they'd be singing too. But
no.
Yes.
No.
Have you seen people do that with the microphone? If the guitarist come in and he's singing like that, the other guy's singing like this.
Yeah, but that's different. There's no microphone there. They're just doing a video. They're just doing a video.
You guys just fucking homophobes.
And there's rumors. And there's rumors. Dude, look at this. Just look it.
I'm looking.
It doesn't matter what he wears.
Look at that. That right there, that's too close, dude.
Where's the follow through? I don't see none after that. Did you just gonna stop right there?
I didn't see the cum shot.
That's too close.
You guys just fucking homophobes.
I'm on the fence right here.
Make out with each other?
Yeah.
Let's have a fag off.
I can put that in later, dude.
Look at him.
And that's too close.
That's not too close. It's fine. It's fine. I don't think you. To suggest it there.
Yeah, Michael Jackson didn't like kids.
Dude, he didn't. That's some bullshit too.
That's why he had an amusement park in his backyard.
He liked rides. He liked roller coasters.
Dude, I fucking love roller coasters.
Did you guys remember that fucking Sim roller coaster park?
I forget the story of... I forget who it was, but someone screamed at another celebrity, and they were just like, he didn't have a childhood. He didn't have a childhood. Do you get it? That's why he loved those rides. That's why he loved playing those games with those kids.
Right. Yeah,
and then, I was just like,
he didn't fuck little kids.
He didn't.
I refuse.
Yeah, he just slept in bed with them.
No, he he crossed lines. Yeah, you can't.
I definitely. All right. So we agree. We agree there. He definitely crossed lines.
Yes.
Sleeping in bed with those kids was definitely crossing the line.
Yes.
But
yes,
I also agree with you on the fact that. Do you think that? Well, let's see if we come to level terms here. Do you agree that some of the family members of the kids were just playing? They probably were just like, oh, my kid's been spending a lot of time at this ultra millionaire's house. Let me take advantage of this. So, and maybe we can make a story and get my kid to corroborate this terrible.
What if you had a kid? I mean, obviously, if you had a kid and then the biggest pop star ever was like, let's have a bunch of us come over.
That's what I'm saying.
You would say, yes, go ahead, go to his amusement park. But then if your kid came back and said, hey, I slept in the same bed as him.
Yeah, yeah, no, exactly.
You're not going to just be like, oh, okay.
Well, yeah,
you're
gonna
be
pissed. If I have a son, and my son's like, can I sleep over
that
house? Yeah, sure. Well, how was, you know, you meet the parent again, you pick up your kid, and then you get in the car, and like, so, what'd you do with Tommy's? Oh, it was great, we did this, we did that, we did this, and then we all got Mr. Tommy Dad's bed, and we all went to bed.
Where's
great.
Tommy?
You know what's weird though?
Where were you?
You know what's weird though? Is if
he said that this bed was comfier.
If there was some random like 35-year-old dude that just walks around town, like say he in Millbury, Mass, like say there's just some random guy that walks around town and he is homeless and he just walks. I fucking hate both of you.
I just need my superior like low calorie beer.
No, but you're Modelo.
Yeah.
Modero. But what I was saying was if there was some random fucking guy that nobody.
But he's not a random guy, Damien. He's not a random guy.
That's.
You can't use the same analogy like that.
Just because somebody made fucking Beat It doesn't mean that they get to rape kids and sleep in the same fucking. In the same bed as them.
He's having a sleepover, dude. That's what you do. That's what you fucking.
No, adults don't have kids sleep over their house.
Well, one time I had a
Dude, kids are way more fun than adults. Why would Michael Jackson want to hang out with adults when they're all like, oh, thank you, Michael Jackson. Nobody's calling him, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's a superstar. We're going to hang out with kids? Kids don't give a fuck. They don't know who you are.
Nobody.
All they know is there's a fucking giraffe back there, roller coasters. My dreams are coming true right now, dude.
Nobody understands me except for kids.
For real, that was honestly, that's the easy escape for him. Instead of being Michael Jackson, which he's been his whole life. Kids don't know he's Michael Jackson. Kids don't give a shit about Thriller. They don't give a shit about Thriller. You know what they give a shit about?
Sleeping in bed with them.
They care about having fun, living in the moment. That's what kids like. That's what he like. That was his fucking escape.
Nightcrawlers.
You're right. The kids did care about having fun. You know what Michael Jackson cared about? Something else.
Having booty? Little child booty?
Well, you know, it is when they are the tightest. And that's a fact.
Oh, who knows, right? No one's ever gonna really know. Except for me, because I'm always right.
That is true.
I am always right. You're right. I am always right. I don't know.
You're not right for wearing tie-dye, that's for sure.
You don't think so?
Nah.
This brings me back, dude. This is how
Yeah, fucking 89.
No, remember when you wore a tie-dye shirt to fucking Tech 9?
Oh, you stuck out like a sore thumb. Should have wore red or black.
I'm not a juggalo. I'm not a juggalo. I'm not a juggalo.
Woot woot, man. Should have just left me alone.
Next time you know how to show up in fucking blood.
I'll never do that. This Modelo is delicious. Brought to you by Modelo. Special.
Yeah, vote for Trump.
Trump.
Fuck Trump. I don't want to hear any other bullshit. Dude, I'm just
Well, two-thirds here.
Dude, I'm just so sick of... I've been just doing this lately because everybody gets all political on Facebook. And I honestly, I'm pretty...
Oh, well, that is the political fucking stamp of this fucking generation. You just post it up on...
Yeah, and I'm guilty. I just share shit all the time with Bernie and Donald Trump. Share shit all the time. People know that I'm pro-Bernie, but now I just do this thing. I just see people, like, go the fuck off. Like, some people, they just write off, like, three paragraphs. Like, you think that socialism is social... They just go off, go to town. I just do a little bit. I say, like, people go, well, I'll tell you what, man. Like, you're not thinking about this demographic, blah, blah, blah. And I just chime in real quick. Feel the burn. Fuck them. Just a little feel the burn. Just a little, meh. And then I love it. They come back at me like, well, Tim, what you gotta understand is... And they go at it again. I don't fucking say anything, or I just come back with FTB. Just little shits, because I like to fuck with them. They want to have a discussion, they can suck my nuts. There you go.
Fuck the black man.
What?
FTB stands for fuck the blacks?
Fuck the blacks.
Feel the burn.
Oh.
You might want to clarify that.
Yeah, dude.
People think you're a wait or...
A racist.
Think you're a racist.
Freaking Elmer Fudd over here.
Think you'll be a racist.
The rabbit is coming and he's gonna be a racist.
What a racist rabbit?
I'm voting for Donald Trump.
Butt stuff 2016.
Butt stuff?
Yeah, you can look up buttstuff2016.com.
Like BUTT stuff?
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Dude, the slogan, I can't look it up, but you can probably look it up real quick. Little Bust Stuff 2016, it's like the change we've all been waiting for, something like that. It's the slogan. Or it's like time for a change, and it's just like Butt Stuff 2016. And they have a website you can go to and you can like donate and shit.
Of course.
Somebody's getting donations for a fake Butt Stuff.
It's not official until you have a fucking GoFundMe.
Go fund my Butt Stuff.
I'll go... Kickstarter.
I'm gonna go start a GoFundMe.
No one's gonna join. We've learned that from your
Bulldogs and Grenades.
Tinder, your Bumble. Wanna plug that thing in?
Bumble?
No, Bumble? But Rocky was talking about how you just made one.
Rocky's not beautiful enough for Bumble. Bumble's for hobby.
Well, he's not white enough.
That too.
People see him, they get scared.
He's gotta stick to the Tinder, dude. You gotta know your level. I told the same thing. My buddy got a Bumble. I told him straight up, I was just like, dude, pretty sure that's just for hot people.
Oh, ooh, well, that was rude.
It was rude, but it's true.
So
why you got to be so rude?
Should I take that as a compliment that you suggested me to bundle? Yeah, bundle.
I suggest you to Tinder.
Ooh. No, you should go to Cupid.
Grindr.
Yeah.
And I'm liking this bundle.
No, what about...
Is it bundle?
You know what? You should go to Growler. You know what Growler is?
Yeah.
For trannies?
It's like for bears.
Big burly gay men.
Hell yeah.
Now, what would I be considered in the gay community? Would I be considered a...
You're an otter.
Probably an otter.
Oh, no. No.
Did you guys... I just watched a Vice thing on... it's called... it's actually kind of ironic. The series is called Balls Deep.
This guy, you're trying to figure out your sexuality. You're confused.
Very confused.
You're curious?
Yeah. I sat down with my girlfriend and we watched...
I'm very curious.
Oh, I'm curious.
Hey, babe, you curious?
We checked it out, see if that was something we could get into, me and her. Yeah, like, yeah. No, but okay, so the series is called Balls Deep. It's on Vice. Vice has their own TV channel now. Fucking fantastic, dude. So much good shit on
there. Yeah, it's so lefty.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
I guess it is. It is pretty left, I guess, if you look at it like that.
Just not too
conservative. A lot of, like, they have a show about weed.
No, yeah, Shane Smith is very lefty. But I like him.
I do too. But so this guy he's the host of Balls Deep, the executive producer or whatever, and he just goes around, it's like the first episode he works in with tent preachers.
Ryan Seacrest.
Yeah, it's Ryan Seacrest.
Balls Deep.
Balls Deep and Ryan Seacrest. And he fucking, they had one, they go to P-Town for Bear Fest or Bears Week or something like that, and it's pretty fucking gay.
I couldn't imagine.
No, but you know what, I gave him mad props because he does some like he lets a gay man like grab his bear cock.
Well, that's very lefty.
Like, this isn't gay. We're just open with our sexuality.
No. Yeah, you guys think I'm close-minded?
Dude, honestly,
watch this!
Honestly, dude, honestly, the gay community, it's gay. They got it pretty good. Everybody's fucking each other. They're very fucking cool. Everybody's, like, accepting, you know what I mean?
Is that what we're
if you were gay, if you were gay, P-Town...
You guys would have to accept me.
You kidding me? I just found out this kid that I know is fucking gay. And you know what?
Did you punch him?
I fucking kicked him out. I kicked him out. I was at the bar. I said, get the fuck out, homo. It's not gay night. That's Wednesday. You come then, bitch.
All right. I'm glad that we're back on track. Because for a second, I had to bow out of the conversation.
Because you're gay?
No, because I was very concerned of where it was going.
I'm just saying, the gay community didn't know what the fuck they're doing. They're having fun.
All right.
They're having sex. They're probably contracting AIDS or an HIV, but they're having a great time.
But that's why you see them all so chipper.
Dude, they're happy as fuck, man. They're doing it right. I wish that the heterosexual community could do that.
That's not the way it goes because
you can't go to vacation.
You fight with your women.
Just have that.
You fight with your woman.
Yeah, but we can't have that. I want that in our community, man.
No, because what happened was we were having that, and then that became rape. Okay. What's going on in the gay community is not rape yet.
There's definitely rape in the gay community.
Oh yeah, but they're not coming out right now.
Oh, they can come out. They definitely come out. If it's rape, it's rape, bud. Yeah,
no,
it's
butt rape.
It's the mindset of the community.
But you know, they're down with the rape.
No, they're not. Nobody's down with rape.
You can't rape the willing, dog.
Yeah, okay, but the
women
mindset.
Aren't willing anymore. All right, that's the problem.
That's why there's so many bears.
For real, the bears are hungry.
Dude, it's like, it was...
Man, bears are so cool.
It looked pretty fucking cool. Dude, I mean, besides the fact that it was like... There was literally like, there's one scene...
Where just a bunch of dudes playing video games fucking each other.
Dude, there was one scene that they went to the pool. Like, the host like met up with some guy and he was like, oh yeah, we're gonna go to, what do they call it? Bear soup? We're gonna go to the pool over here. We call it bear soup. It just fucking... It looked disgusting. It was just a bunch of hairy, fat men in a fucking in-ground pool.
Frothy
just,
mess.
Like, I'm talking full. I'm talking packed.
Ugh.
Like inner city, like, ooh. 102 degrees out, like, fucking public pool.
I gotta go to the bathroom and...
But with just, dude, like, literally bear soup, like, it looked fucking disgusting. But...
I must use the restroom from 5 to 7 minutes.
You can't, dude, you can't, like, you wouldn't have that in the heterosexual community. Like, if I went on vacation...
Yes,
not,
you
spend more of your time on vacation away from other people.
Have you ever seen what Cancun or Miami looks like during spring break?
Roofland everywhere.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
But that's exactly what you're talking about.
I guess you're right.
It's just, yeah, it's a fucking swimming pool full of fucking people ass grabbing and fucking sexually assaulting each other, but no one cares.
Yeah, you're true. All right. I stand corrected. You're right. I didn't get to that. And also, it was Bears Week in the episode, so you're right. It was like a spring break.
Yeah, it's just all on. It all depends on what you're
spring
looking for.
Break for bears.
And if you're looking for bears, you're gonna see bears.
A lot of bears, I'll tell you right now, man. That shit was gross.
Are they all coming out of hibernation?
Dude, the host described it as like the worst smelling locker room. He's like, this is like the worst smelling locker room that I've ever been in.
Oh, I wish I could trap that smell in a jar.
Or a candle.
And
bear soup.
Oh.
Scented candle.
Yankee special.
The water is so cold.
Divorce
you
papers.
Really could just have it like a wax.
Oh. Yeah, so.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I don't know how we started on that rant.
Well, you were talking about how you had a secret to tell everybody. I think it started off with us talking about how you were wearing tie-dye, actually.
It was the kid. Something about, if I was a bear, who would I be or whatever. An otter, and I was surprised you knew that, because I didn't know that there were, like, different divisions of that,
yeah.
And they went through it on the segment.
Well, yeah, I had just...
I was like, oh, I didn't know, like, that you knew that.
I just found out about it not that long ago.
Yeah, there's, like, bears, there's otters. Old men are polar bears.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, dude. Like, white-haired old men, they're called polar bears, dude. How funny is that?
That's the first time I heard that one.
The funny one was, like...
And I'm interested.
They shot over, too. Okay, so they have otters.
Which I'm not. All right. So what's an otter technically?
It's like a smaller, an infant, in shape, like a bear.
All right. So Derek's not that. So Derek's not that.
Okay.
We were mistaken. What's the halfway? What's the halfway between bear and otter?
A boar.
There's a naked bear. I forgot what the naked bear was called. It was called something else.
Mole rat.
Something like that.
Derek's a mole rat.
No,
you're a mole. You're a mole.
I'm 25 though.
And then,
yeah, the naked mole rat.
The funniest one, they did this like the polar bears, like the old guys, and like, shoots like a couple like older, like just white haired, hairy fat fucks. And then there's like, and then you got the panda bears. And it was just like a fat Asian dude.
Oh.
They call them pandas, like they refer to themselves as panda bears.
What the hell?
How funny is that?
So, what's an old Asian man?
He's a panda. He's a panda bear, I guess.
He can be a pandola bear?
I don't know. I don't know how that works, but. I just thought it was funny.
Yeah, well, we all have our own standards, Derek.
I knew about bears. I thought it was just general across the board. If you're a bear, you're a bear. Like a polar bears, panda bears. Pretty funny. Pretty funny shit.
You.
So what I get out of it is a twink.
What? What's a twink?
Oh, no.
See, you went to the fun furry animals.
Yeah, I was going to say, like everybody's a bear or like some sort of animal. Yeah, sounds like there's a furry convention going on.
Power bottoms? Bottoms, twanks.
What is that?
Oh.
Well, I know. Bottom is you take it in the butt.
You know, a power bottom is somebody
who takes it in the butt, but they fuck back.
They're able to take ungodly punishment to their asshole. So like, whether that be 10 guys, like one
no,
after
stop,
another,
stop.
Or like Damien said.
So how do we know so much about it?
Yeah, how do you guys know? I watched the special like literally like a day ago. How do you guys know about
it? We're cultured.
No,
cultured.
Ever since the internet came out, you know?
We're democratic.
Pouring out new stuff, you know?
Since 98,
so what the
you know?
What was that when you called me?
A twink is
twink?
A...
No, twink.
No, a twink.
Like a
it's not twank.
Yeah, it's twink.
It's not, it's not like T-W...
Twank?
Yeah, yeah, I was about to say that. Yeah. It's not twank.
I'm pretty sure
it's twink.
A little bit of twang on it.
Derek... Just like earlier when we were talking about oil, chucks right, and right. checks.
All right, never mind. Damien is more educated on the games.
Apparently.
No, well, earlier in the day, we were talking about a wrestling move, which is falls right into this conversation. It's called an oil check, which is...
Check their oil.
Which is... Yeah, you fucking... In order to gain a better position, you, like, use your fingers and kind of... You grip their ass, and yeah, you try to get a better position.
That's gross.
But Derek thought it was an oil chuck, and I reassured him it's an oil check. And I believe this is another one of those situations.
Oh, so there is a twink and a twink.
But the one that we were talking about is a twink. The one that we were both thinking of was definitely.
Why do I represent this? Why would?
It's because it's a
actually,
no. It's a small skinny. Teenager.
Often androgynous case, Sprite. Usually it is 20.
Sprite?
You see this variety. And
they're supposed to look. And they're supposed to look like boyish. Like
yeah,
it's a
boyish young gay. And that twink is an over the hill boyish young gay.
Wait. So wait. What's the? Oh, so that's an old.
A twink is an old twink.
That's all right.
Like
yeah.
Probably like my biggest insecurity probably is that I go somewhere and people think
so this so yeah it's not that I knew it's not that I knew too much
tight-eyed shirts don't help
you think so
yeah that definitely doesn't help
you know,
they
no
the Bernie
the
thing
what
yeah that doesn't
my
help either
views,
yeah oh yeah oh yeah definitely and
definitely
and
brother,
and
not a fucking queer.
And really, before
is that a gay now
definitely
what.
Well, no.
Is it?
No.
No, it's not.
No, it's very Jerry Garcia, but...
It's a strobe of ganja.
But it's also very...
It's got bands on the back, like
but,
booty stick.
But it's also very, like, Boy George. It's also very Boy George, too.
Boy George is glitter. He's glam.
Yeah.
This
exactly.
Tie-dye.
No, dude, it's okay. It's very Freddie Mercury of you. You know what I'm saying?
I love Freddie Mercury.
Yeah, he's good. And Derek, you cuckahead, we're coming at me saying, "Oh well, you it's not my."
If you knew more about the gay community.
I just looked on my phone.
No, but you knew that there was such thing as a twink.
And you knew it was a twink.
But everybody knows that it's twink.
So twink is.
Everybody knows.
Yeah, apparently everybody knows.
No, but twink isn't. Twink isn't the normal one. Twink is the normal one.
I don't know. I've heard twink.
Twank?
Boys are twink.
I don't know.
Are there terms for the heterosexual community like this?
It's called MILF.
Yeah, it's called GILF.
Fucking a DILF.
It's called giving to the dick. It's
called victim.
Hit it. The victim?
Victim.
It's called
victim.
It's called pussy.
Power top, aka care. Rapist.
The gangbang. The gangbanger.
Oh. What happened?
It looks like the podcast is about to be over, boys.
No, I just need to put the battery in.
Looks like meat's back on the menu.
We've been filming for 70 minutes anyway, so.
Yeah, let's end off on a high note. Talking about gay fucking.
Yeah.
Yep.
Here's some Triptoons coming at you. Like, subscribe, download the music.
Yeah.
Go to the website.
Yeah. Okay.